Hi everyone, my name is Michelle and I'm Mama Loves You GB. Welcome to the 10th and the 11th of December. Yes, I'm doing two in one today because I didn't get to film yesterday. Yesterday, which was, well, it was the 9th, but I would have filmed for the 10th, was the production at my school and they did Grease. Now my lab is right next door to the hall where they've been practicing. So for the last 2 months, and more specifically, constantly for the last 2 weeks, I've heard all the songs, heard all the music, and so I couldn't wait to go and see it. And they didn't disappoint. It was absolutely fabulous. I wish I could bottle the feeling that I get from watching the production and just keep it all year, because I can't. Sometimes it just gets a bit too much, but that feeling that you get at the end of the production, and I haven't had anything to do with it, I'm just going along as a punter, that feeling that you get at the end of the production, wish I could just keep it all year round. It would be fabulous. And then today we went to meet Father Christmas. So one of the National Trust properties, which is reasonably local to us, is called Deneva. It's just outside Carmarthen. Well, it's actually in Llandilo. They do a brilliant Santa, really good. So you have a little elf that takes you down into the basement and it shows you all of the Santa storeroom and the place where the reindeer sleep, and it's all marked out. And then you go in and you meet Father Christmas and another elf, and you get a good long time actually chatting. I'm talking a bit quiet because he's still awake. Good long time talking to the main man himself. So, and it snowed. It snowed while we were there. It was snowing all the time we were driving there, and it snowed properly when we were actually there. So I might put some pictures in because I've got some nice footage in the snow. If you follow me on Instagram, you will see that the day turned the colour of my hair. There was snow everywhere. It was brilliant. It was brilliant. So I've got pretty much two episodes worth. I've got two of those to open, I've got two of those to open, I've got two of the doors to open. I've got some stitching to show you, a little bit of haul that's come in, some stitchy kindness, a couple of Christmas cards, that sort of thing to show you. So we're going to start off, as we always do, with what is now known as the Home for Captured Children. So one of the comments yesterday was thinking that we might be getting a Peeping Tom today. So let's have a look and see if we've got a Peeping Tom today. Oh, we've got an angel keeping watch over a sleeping child there. Let's just check, nothing untoward is going on. If you look at the face of the child, it actually looks more like a middle-aged man, slightly balding. But there we go. We do have an angel looking over a small baby-faced man. And then number 11 is over here. Oh, she's happy. Looks like she's got breakfast in bed. Probably suffering from some kind of Victorian illness, but having breakfast in bed instead. But it does, it looks like she's got a bun. And she's having a wake-up time. She looks very happy. There we go. So that's the Home for Captured Children. Right, let me show you what I've been stitching on. I am still stitching on this, which is my increasingly battered copy of Evergreen. Now, had I really realised what would have happened to this chart, I would have taken a photocopy, but this is one of the new, you could tell by the look on my face then, couldn't you? I have one of those faces that doesn't lie, unfortunately. If you listen to what I'm saying, but then look at my face, you'll see what's really going on. Yeah, so this is one of these flimsy charts. So I wish I'd taken a copy of it. So it's not gonna be worth the paper it's written on by the end of it. But there we go. So I have done, look at that. Look at the state of that. Is that attached? No. That's just extra green. There we go. So that's where I am. I've pretty much finished the fox, except he's got some snow to sit on. I've outlined the dove. The dove from above. Which will probably only make sense to you if you watched Shooting Stars in the mid sort of 90s. The dove from above. And this will be a polar bear. So I'm still really enjoying working on it. Still really enjoying working on it. I haven't felt like I needed to change just yet. But we'll see. We'll see. Changes of stitching normally just hit me rather than are planned. Okay. So let's have a look at these two, 10 and 11. Oh, another Philip Kingsley. We're doing all right for Philip Kingsley this time. What have we got this time? Elasticizer. Now, I do like the elasticizer. I have got a big tub of it, thank you to my mother. But I do like the elasticizer. That's a very good little travel-sized one. So we've pretty much got a whole travel-sized Philip Kingsley now, which is marvellous. And number 11. Ooh. Clinique dramatically different moisturizing lotion. I used to swear by this, absolutely swear by it. I haven't used it for a little while though, so it'll be interesting to see whether my skin still likes it. I kind of went off of it while I was pregnant. When I was pregnant, I got really bad sort of acne just under my skin there, which occasionally flares up. Sometimes if you see like a little bit of high colour on my cheeks, it's that usually. And I kept that kind of, at that time it didn't work. So mind you, it probably couldn't have worked on it. I think I ended up having some medication for it. But I'll give that another whirl when I've finished my current moisturiser. Although I do really like that Origins one that we had the other day. That was really nice. So let's have a look at some Stitchy Kindness. So I had this beautiful card in the post from Sue. She also sent me a Patrick Rabbit gift voucher. Thank you so much, Sue. Really wasn't any need to do that, but it was lovely. She's written such a nice note inside. But yeah, thank you, Sue. I shall enjoy picking out a project in your honour for that. Thank you. And then I had a card from Kerry, who is Roxy Flosco. Now, I'm starting to call it Roxy Flosco because as of the 1st of January, she is switching her name from Leo and Roxy Floss to Roxy Flosco. So I was watching their, it's called Between Two Whips. It's the one that she does with Caroline from Evertotes. The what do you call it? YouTube, FlossTube. What am I doing right now? FlossTube. And it's an absolute hoot. You've got to go and watch it. And she was saying that as of the 1st of January, that's when the name is going to change over. Although they have got quite a few little tags to use up with the old name on it. But officially, it'll be Roxy Flosco by then. So she sent me a lovely little card. So thank you very much for that, Kerry. Who else have I been watching on FlossTube? Let's try and have a little think who I've watched over the last few days. I caught up with Amanda, Alba Stitcher. I am just about to start Amy Loves Toads. I know she has just uploaded a new video. I've been watching Brenda and the Serial Starter, so Brenda and Laura. I tend to watch theirs in bits, so I'm about halfway through theirs. Jen Upton I've watched recently. Who else? I'm sure there's loads of people. Rebel Stitcher. But yeah, those are just a little flavour of some of the things that I've been watching. Some of the channels that I've been watching. That wasn't very polite of me, was it? Some of the channels that I've been watching. Okay, well, let's have a look at a couple of freebies then. So I have stuck with a freebie, one for technically yesterday and one for technically today. So it doesn't really matter which way round they go. I'm going to go with this one first, and I will just fold this one. Now this is called Joy by Misty Purcell from Luminous Fiber Arts, and I just think it's an absolutely darling little ornament. You could definitely knock that up between now and Christmas. The chart is sort of about 45 by about 45. Does it say specifically? 48 by 46. There we go. And she used Vintage Country Mocha and a red. Does it say what red? No. Oh, ribbon red. Ribbon red. There we go. But love that. And the second freebie that I have picked out is called Wear Love by Kathy from Hands On Design. Now every year Kathy designs a sort of Valentine's love chart for her husband, and this is the one for is it this year's one or is it last year's one? 2021. And it says Wear Love Everywhere You Go, and it's got that lovely floral sort of border underneath. So this is not a Christmas one for Advent. I'm trying to give you freebies that you can use all the way through the year. So there is that one. Love it. That is 32 count espresso linen and it's 88 by 48. But I think that would be a really, really lovely stitch. It's nearly gone. I thought I was going to get all the way through without coughing today, but no such luck. Okay, my two previous finishes this year. One is not yet FFO'd, and it is by Colleen, Rebel Stitcher. And this is called Una's Urn. I really liked stitching this one. Originally, it wasn't going to be available. That's not true. It was available in the UK, posted from Colleen, but the post was more than the chart. So I had a chat with her on Instagram, and she was like, well, let me check with a friend. And she was able to put it into PDF, and she's actually started selling more of her charts by PDF so that we in the UK can get our hands on them because they are amazing. And this is Una's Urn, I can't remember if I said that. 32 count hand-dyed linen that I dyed myself. If you want to see how I dyed this one, if you go on to my tutorial from probably a couple of years ago now about using walnut inks, I just put it in a spray bottle and sprayed this one and I loved it. And it's actually the back because I preferred the paler side for this stitch. So there's that one. I really want to make that into a pillow. I've just got to get the sewing machine out, which is looking more likely now. The kitchen is looking more like a kitchen. And this is the second one. Still catches me unaware sometimes. The chart for this is actually in my red sampler pack. So I charted three red samplers, I think, and put them together in a pack. And then I also put the chart in for this teeny tiny little pincushion. It does have a couple of needles in it. And on the back, it's just got an antique mother of pearl button. So that's what it looks like on the back, and then it's got a little bead border, and there's instructions on how to put this together. Now I designed this because I had watched on eBay a cushion, pin cushion about this size, sell for about £300, and I thought, that is beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Whoops. However, I'm sure we can do something similar. So this is stitched over one on 28 count, I believe, and is just a simple little alphabet with a bead border. I really like this. Love, love, love it. Let me put it somewhere where I'm not going to lose it again. Okay, just a little tiny bit of haul, and it really is a little bit of haul. It's not even terribly stitch related, although I am counting it as a new bag to put some of my projects in, and it's immediately getting tangled up with the home for captured children. So I saw this advertised on Facebook. It actually came from the States. It's got a blue handle and then a red handle. And what I like about it is that it's got a good gusset. I like a good gusset on a bag. And I think that'd be perfect for putting in a few project bags. Now, it came from this company called Hoodies for Heroes. And they make a big donation from each of the bags sold to a charity. Now, it doesn't say on the card which particular charity this was, and I can't remember offhand, but it was a mental health suicide prevention charity. I can't remember the exact name of it, but it's just plain on the back. But that is where I got it from, and like I said, it came from America. So yeah, Hoodies for Heroes. If you just Google Hoodies for Heroes, you'll find their Instagram and their shop and all. But yeah, I just thought it was such a sweet little bag with such an important message and such an important charity to donate to, especially this time of year, or group of charities. I can't even remember if it was just one or not. But yeah, it was definitely mental health, suicide prevention. I'm gonna pop that there. So let's see what we've got in the patchwork rabbit. Oops, just chucked everything on the floor. So, number 10, sat on top of my lovely Santa made for me by Louise. So, who have we got this time? We have got Teal Frost, which is kind of like a bluey green, as the name would suggest. There we go. So I shall add this to my ring. I just like seeing them build up. I just love seeing them all build up. And I don't know if you've been watching anyone who's been who had the Evertote advent calendar. They've been doing a stitch along at the same time with the flosses that came out. So it'd be nice to include all of these flosses in a single stitch, because they do really complement one another. And this is the 11th. And this time we have got endive. Now, you can never have enough endive. Endive crops up here, there and everywhere. So you can never have enough endive. So there we are. That's it from me today. I think I'm going to do some of the tasty treats tomorrow. I might spread it out over a couple of days, maybe. We'll see how tasty they actually are. And then I'm planning also to do a little bit of a kind of festive chart parade as well in one of the forthcoming episodes. Because one night in the next few days, I'm going to have to film two in the same night, because we are going to one of those lit walks. That's not described it very well, has it? So they put on all these brilliant lights and you sort of take a walk through, and it's at the National Botanical Gardens of Wales. So we're going to go and do that in the next couple of nights. So I will be filming one episode or two episodes on the same night for that. So I think I might do a kit parade on one of those nights as well. Not a kit parade. A festive chart parade. There we go. Just one last look at all those lovely flosses, and I will see you tomorrow. Stay classy, stitches.